This is Easy 107.5 FM.
A weakened what should be a strong, independent state institution. It proved to me who my real friends are. It showed the pettiness of some of our so-called leaders. October 10th was an embodiment of politics of exclusion. Indeed, it stood as a symbol of our national governance by exclusion. It made me begin to realize how naive I had been about politics in Ghana. The idea that we do it to serve our many people was broken. They rejoice because by elimination, one of them would win. No need to wonder a what if. Truly, it broke our campaign. Let me say that one again. Truly, it broke our campaign. 4 years of organizing, hard work, emotions, and huge investments of our hard-earned Ghanaian money from party faithful. Gone. Campaign contribution pledges disappeared. The opponents had a field day. They immediately went to the field. They told our parliamentary candidates to give up. They told our supporters that our party was no longer in the race. And they asked, how can you have a living body without a head? We put on a brave face, but we knew that we had been dealt a fatal blow. So now, when someone tells me Ghanaians have decided that we should have a two-party state, I know, and you see how I know, that to many of our people, politics is a means. It's a means to get a good job, decent house, nice car, and high status in society. And I know, because to some big people, politics is a means to get that big government contract and loads of free cash. And I know because to the many poor, politics means that election time will come so that they can get something that within the 4 years they will not get, something in exchange for their votes. And so, my real friends, October 10th, 2016 and after, they kept yelling. My real friends and family, they kept yelling, why do you want to do this? And they kept repeatedly asking, why do you want to do this? I continue to campaign to keep our candidates and poor supporters in the field. And yet, those people kept asking, why are you campaigning when you have been disqualified? And those were my random thoughts. And my random thoughts, because if you don't think that October 10, 2016 had a strong effect on me, think again. You see, in the year 2000, I competed to become a member of parliament for Kamenda, Edna Iwasu-Agrin. And at the end of the election, so many things happened when they were counting the votes and when we got to the collation center. Too many negative things to want to talk about here. I knew that I had been cheated out of the few votes that would have made me an MP on that day. But I have faith in the system, so I went to court. But the case stayed in court for the entire 4 years until the next election, when the Electoral Commission asked me, can they remove the old votes from 2000 from the ballot boxes so that they can conduct the 2004 election? I took that. And I went on to find different ways to campaign for the 2004 election. So you see, I've always kept faith in the system. But I'll tell you, 10th October 2016 broke that faith. It broke it. You ask me, do I have faith in the Electoral Commission? In the system we have, definitely not. Not when the commissioners themselves are now telling us some of them transferred votes illegally, that some of them created polling stations and we didn't know. And they did all sorts of acts, including some allegedly trying to sell votes so some people could win. So that faith is gone. But I want to also let you know that we have laws. And one of those laws, the protector of that law, is supposed to be the Electoral Commission. And it's the Political Parties Act of 2000. Inside that act, there are certain provisions there that say that every citizen of voting age has the right to participate in political activity intended to influence the composition and policies of the government, and that nobody should attempt to take anybody's freedoms under the Political Parties Act away from them. And indeed, it says, any person who suppresses or attempts to suppress the lawful political party or a political activity of another person commits an offense and shall, on summary conviction, be liable to a minimum fine of 2 million cedis or to imprisonment for a term not exceeding 5 years or to both. So what do we say to the Electoral Commission? So some may also say that, oh, it happened to you, it was just you. Well, if it happened to me, it happened to you. If somebody takes my freedom away, they can take your freedom away as well. Some say, ah, but in the end, the courts said you would contest the election. That's neither here nor there. You shouldn't have to be go to court, as they kept saying. It's a state institution that was supposed to use its own laws to ensure that everybody's rights were protected. So my point here today is that those actors who did what they did deliberately in a premeditated fashion, those actions we cannot forget. And we must also ensure that, you see, politics is not just about who wins and who loses. It's a process, it's a helpful activity. And someday we should all take a look at what has happened to African presidents from Ghana's independence on to now. Take a look at what happened to them. Take a look at what has happened to their countries. Take a look at what has happened to their reputations. And take a look at how some of them had even lost their lives while they were in office in a violent way. And we must measure what we say and what we do. And in Ghana, you know, there are a number of people, they look at you and they say, why does he want to do this? Or why does she want to do that? And they pray for people to fail. But when you pray for people to fail, they forget that each one of us individuals, we make up the nation. So if you pray for individuals to fail, you pray for the nation to fail. We must pray for all of us to get stronger, to succeed. So in order to not to make this something very long, I have a few suggestions. Number one, to give it a better chance of becoming independent. Members of the Electoral Commission should not be chosen by the President alone. Parliament and political parties in good standing should participate in the process. And the Electoral Commission should be given technical assistance to develop and implement rules and procedures to ensure that political parties comply conditions of their certification. And again, the Electoral Commission should be given technical assistance to develop rules and procedures to ensure that only Ghanaians fund political parties and their campaigns, and also prevent the use of state funds by parties in power to fund their parties and campaigns. And lastly, let me suggest to Ghanaians that we Ghanaians must not support the two-party agenda. A two-party dictatorship is one step away from a de facto one-party state. And indeed, when you have two heads, two parties with one body, that's no choice. Our people must support alternatives so we would strengthen our infant democracy. So what I know for sure is that I, Papa Kwesi Mainu, will never forget 10th October 2016 and the pain and destruction it caused me, the Progressive People's Party. I will never forget the players who orchestrated what happened that day. And I pray for them to live long, long, for them to also every day remember 10th October 2016. But they underestimate the will of the determined, the will of the focused, and the will of the progressives. When you get the chance, I'll send to you, read what I wrote back in 2012 about why I decided to contest to become president of this republic we call Ghana. I will not go through that here. When you get a chance, read it, we'll send it to you. So, God live the Progressive People's Party. And God bless our homeland, Ghana. Thank you.